There's so many things I could say about that episode of the X-Files, because that was the most personal episode to me of the X-Files, because it's about being right. And I wanted to do that because I realized at that point I had spent so many thousands of hours with Mulder and Scully, thinking about them, watching them on the phone, editing them, everything. They were real people to me. They were like some of the most important people in my life, and they don't exist. And I thought that's remarkable. Yes. Well, maybe I should also say that.
Alors, en fait, tellement je suis d'accord sur cet épisode, parce que oui, cet épisode était véritablement nourri du fait d'être auteur, d'être scénariste. Ce qui est très curieux, c'est qu'avec les années, à force de travailler sur X-Files, les personnages de Mulder et Scully étaient devenus presque réels, à force de les écrire, de voir sur l'écran, ces personnages étaient devenus les personnes les plus importantes de sa vie, sauf qu'elles n'étaient pas réelles.
The idea of the writer pulling out his heart, I told Sullivan this. I've been doing this a long time now, I've been doing this for 20 years. And still, every time I write a script, there is a point of desperation. There is a point I reach where I feel like I don't know how to do this, I don't know how to make it good. And I wish I could tell you that it was an act, I wish I could tell you that it's a charming affectation, but I genuinely suffer every time I write a script. And it can last for a couple of days or a week. It's not writer's block. It's this sense that I haven't really figured out what's at the heart of the story. And eventually, it passes. I get to the point where I feel like I have. And I move on, and I believe. But there is that suffering that I guess I need to go through to make sure I've exhausted whatever it is I have to say every time. Unfortunately.
Alors, ça peut paraître comme une histoire folle.